important questions from organic chemistry part, and I have chosen questions in such a way that these are usually asked in all kinds of entrances and specifically for your PG entrance examination. We have done some previous questions. Now it is important to go through some subject specific question. That's why I'm going to do organic chemistry part today. And don't worry, whatever I have did in the subject part, like chromatography, spectroscopy, all those I did keeping in mind the repeated questions. Don't worry, in QSAT also, I discuss the important repeated portions, whatever topics I have given, I am trying to cover the questions from that as well. Now, let's begin with this. So, the first question given here is 2-hexane gives trans-2-hexene. So, in these kinds of questions, what is really they are asking? We need a reagent which will be converting the triple bond into stereospecific double bond, that is trans 2, trans or cis. Whenever such question comes with the triple bond, two reagents you have to keep in mind. One is the PdBSO4 and other the lithium and ammonium. This is the Lindler's catalyst, and this would be giving cis products, cis alkene. Okay, and in lithium and ammonium, this would be giving the trans alkene. So, what would be the answer here? The answer of this question would be D. Usually, in these kinds of questions, you don't even have to check for anything more. Just remember these two reagents and you got the answer. As simple as that. Now, we will go to the second question. So, the second question is, aqueous sulfuric acid reacts with 2-methyl-but-1-ene to predominantly give. So, we have to find the major product of this particular reaction. So, this is the structure of 2-methyl-but-1-ene. Okay. Now, what is the question? Aqueous sulfuric acid. Most of you would think you have to do something with sulfate and the product would be either A or D. But it is wrong. Here it is. What we are actually doing is the reaction is with water, with H plus as the acid mediated OH addition is what we are doing here. And since it is H2SO4, what would be the mechanism? It would be addition of OH group would be following Markovnikov's rule. So, Markovnikov's rule means the electronegative part will be going to the carbon containing least number of hydrogen, or in other words, highly substituted carbon. In that place, it would be going. So, out of these two, in one of the places, it can go, the OH group. But according to Markovnikov's rule, it should go to this particular carbon because this is having least number of hydrogen and also this is having two different carbon substitution. And here we have only hydrogen as the substitution. So, what would be our product? Product would be CH3CH2CH. Here we would be having OH. CH3 would be remaining here. Single bond CH3. So, this would be our product. And what is this? This is 2-methyl-butan-2-ol. Option B would be the right answer. So, the method that we are using here is Markovnikov's rule, since the acid given to us is sulfuric acid. I hope you understand. Now, we'll go to the third question. The third question we have here is, we are given butene, then NBS, you know that N-bromosuccinic acid. So, NBS is there and we'll get a product X. And that X-on reacting with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, what we would get a product Y, and we have to find Y. So, the whole point behind this kind of question is, you need to know where the bromination would take place if you are reacting with NBS. So, here we are having, rewrite it, CH3CH2CH double bond CH2. So, whether the bromination would take place in this, that is our question. So, what you have to remember is NBS would be forming allylic bromination. So, what is allylic group? Allylic group means the group which is next to the one which is having double bond. So, here two, this and this are having double bond. So, the allylic position would be this carbon atom. So, what would happen? a bromination would take place like this: CH3, CH2Br, CH, double bond CH2. And in the next step, we have to do with alcoholic KOH. With alcoholic KOH, dehydrohalogenation would take place. Dehydrohalogenation means the hydrogen and the bromine from here would be gone, and we would get the 1,3-butadiene, CH2, here only CH would be the CH, CH double bond, CH2. So option C would be the right answer. So the whole point behind this question is to understand NBS would be brominating at the allylic position, and after that, when alcoholic KOH is treated, what will be happening? There will be dehydrohalogenation, and that's why this is a concert mechanism. This will be happening here, and the bromine will be leaving, and therefore we'll get a double bond, and 1,3-butadiene would be our product. This is the third question. Now we'll go to the fourth one. Two questions would be the trend in certain properties. These questions are also frequently asked. Here they are asking the order of boiling point in case of alkali halides, and the answer would be option D, because for an alkyl halide, for any alkyl halide, the boiling point would be changing in this order. That is, the iodide will be having greater boiling point than bromide, then it would be fluoride, and then finally it would be fluoride. So that's a very simple question. The next question, you need to think a little. So here different substituted phenols are given, and we are asked to understand the decreasing acidity order. So first of all, you have to understand what is acidity, or the acid behavior means it should give H plus. And when it is giving H plus, whatever conjugate base it is forming, how much cable the conjugate base is, that much acidic it would be. So on losing H plus, it will be forming O minus. This minus should be stabilized, and only then what would happen, in other words, here the more electron withdrawing group will be giving the better result, or the minus M and minus I effect would be giving better acidity, and plus M and plus I effect will be decreasing the acidity. So here the one with both minus I and minus M is the para-nitrophenol. So that would be having the greatest acidity. So 3 is correct. Then comes chlorine. Chlorine is having minus I effect. Here we are having both minus M and minus I. So this would be the greatest acidity. Then here we don't have minus M, but we have minus I effect. So this would be having the second highest acidity. Now these two are having plus I effect is there, or plus M effect is also there for this. So plus M effect will be decreasing it the most. This is having plus I, but no less, still lesser than OCH3 group. So the third biggest acidity will be for the methyl substituted phenol, and finally it would be OCH3. So what would be our order? 3 greater than 1, greater than 2, greater than 4. So 4. I hope you understood. If some group is having both minus M and minus I effect, that would definitely increase the acidity of the phenol. And if there is no minus M effect, and then check for minus I effect. So here minus I effect is given by chlorine, then that would be giving the next acidity. After that, you have to check for the order in plus M and plus I effect. If you have two groups, one with plus I effect and plus M effect, the one with plus I effect would be having the next bigger acidity, because methyl group, the M effect would be more prominent than the inductive effect. So we will be trying to think likewise, and that is why our answer would be option B. Now we will go to the sixth question. The next question we have today, we have a cyclohexane ring. There is a CH3 group and a Br group and CH3OH. And we should get a major product A. So which of these would be the product? That is our question. So basically what we need to know, this is a substitution reaction, and the substitution that this one would follow is SN1 substitution. That is, there would be formation of a carbocation. So if the carbocation is formed,
what is, where would be the carbocation be formed? CH3 is here and the bromine would be gone and the carbocation would be formed here. But this is a secondary carbocation. So what would happen? A hydride shift, an H minus shift would occur. And the hydride from this position would be shifted to here. And the carbocation would be rearranged to form a tertiary carbocation. Here at this position, tertiary carbocation. Why? Because tertiary is more stable than the secondary carbocation and therefore the rearrangement occurs. Even when I started to discuss about the rearrangement, the reactions, and I told you that in case of substitution and reaction, most of the times you have to see about the stability of the carbocation. If there is possibility of a more stable carbocation by rearrangement of some group, then definitely that would happen. So here actually a secondary carbocation was to be formed, and but since the possibility of a more stable tertiary carbocation at this particular position is there, so this hydride will be shifting and we will get a tertiary carbocation, and the OCH3- will now come at this position. So our answer would be option B. Very simple. So whenever you have these kinds of substitution reaction, first of all check whether it is SN1 or SN2. Here it is SN1 reaction, and I have already told in some of the previous video how to identify whether SN1 or SN2. If you still don't know that, please comment below. I'll be telling you the how to identify whether it is SN1 or SN2. So if carbocation formation is there, then what would happen? There would be better stable carbocation formation if it is there, then such a rearrangement would take place. That is what happened here, and our option B would be the answer.
What type of questions that can come in the examination, that is they would give you one particular step from the reaction mechanism and you will ask you to identify that belongs to which of the reaction mechanism they gave in the option. And the trend of this kinds of question is that only common reaction will be asked, because some unknown reaction, if they ask any step from the reaction mechanism, it would be impossible for you to write. So only very well known reaction, most important reactions only they will ask. So here what is the question? Which one of the following reaction involve a hydride shift in its reaction mechanism? We have already discussed all four of these reaction mechanisms. And I will be putting the link of this in the description box. Please watch all these if you have not watched it, because these are very important. And you know the answer is Cannizzaro reaction, because in Cannizzaro reaction, in one of the step, the hydride, that is the H minus, would be going and attacking the second carbonyl carbon, and that is why hydride shift is involved in one of its step of the reaction mechanism. So the answer is option 3, Cannizzaro reaction. Okay. Now we'll go to the 8th question. The question coming for your exam is the one belonging to this category. That is, you will be having different sets of carbonyl carbons and it will be asked you to find the reagent used for the particular transformation. So in these kinds of questions, what you have to do is first observe the reactant and the product carefully. In the we can see here there is one ketone is there, and here we have a COOOCH3, which means an ester. So here we have an ester as well as a carbonyl group, and the reduction of only the ketone group has taken place here. That is to alcohol, it has taken place. So the major reagents that will come into your mind will be lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride. And now you know specifically lithium aluminium hydride, if it was used, both the carbon will be reduced to alcohol. But what happened here? Only one, that is the ketone, has been reduced to the alcohol, and so it is specific, and therefore our answer should be NaBH4, that is sodium borohydride. It is very simple. Just the strategies for these kinds of question is to observe the reactant and the product side and identify what are the changes that has happened, and then look through the options accordingly. Okay, we'll go to the 9th question. This is an extremely important question. Here what would happen? The product, this is an important question from carbohydrates. Please study this by heart, because anytime this question can come. The product of the following reaction is, so what is happening? Glucose with HCN, then H3O+, then the reduction with P and HI. What would be our product? That's the question. So we'll look through the series of the reaction.
First, this is the structure, that is CHO, CHOH 4 times, CH2OH is the formula for glucose. When HCN comes, there will be C minus will be attacking this, then this double bond will be shifting to OH, O minus will be there, and the H plus will be attacking there. So in that case, we will get CH, one extra CHOH, and the CN also will be attacking. That is, the number of carbon atom is increased. In the next step, what would happen? H3O plus would be, H3O plus would hydrolyze the cyanide group into carboxylic acid. And already we are having, including this one, now we are having 5-CHOH group. And then reduction take place, and the CHOH, that is all the alcohol, gets reduced to alkyl groups. And what would happen? There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 5, 6, and 7. There are 7 carbon atom, and this is a carboxylic acid. So it would be N-heptanoic, this is heptanoic, not heptanoic. A normal heptanoic acid would be the answer. Why? Because normal, this is a single straight chain acid. The number of carbon atom increased, and also this is the series of the steps that is followed. Very important part from carbohydrate. Now we'll go to the final question of the day. This is another very important question. This is from the part of ozonolysis, and cyclohexane is given. We have ozone and also zinc dust with water. What would be our product? This is something that you could study by heart, because the option B would be our answer. We will be having CHO group, this double bond, this bond will be fully broken, and we will be having CHO, CHO in both these positions. So that is the important product. Why? Because in some of the exams, further reaction can be asked. That is, from this, they can give some more reagent, like KOH if they are given. Then what you should do? From this, there are 2 carbonyl groups, and further aldol condensation will occur. So if they are giving more reagents, you have to work out accordingly. So in order to do that, you should remember the first step, so that you don't need to do, you can save time without writing the mechanism of the first step. You only would need to work out the second step if further reagents are given. Here we don't have this, and so our product is option B. So that's all for today. So today we have chosen 10 different organic questions that is important for all exams, especially for your PG entrances, because I have gone through different question papers, and the commonly asked important portions from organic chemistry we have stressed today, like SN1 reaction, we have done that. Then some of the name reactions, then about the acidity and boiling point, the trends like that, and then the carbohydrate, one of the important reactions. So we have mixed up, and we have done some of the most important parts we have covered today, and I hope you all are preparing really well. Prepare more and work hard so that you will be all getting a higher score. And thank you all for your 1000 plus subscribers. All the best for each one of you, and thank you. Subscribe our channel, hit the bell icon, and for latest notification you have to hit the bell icon. Share this video to all your friends. Thank you so much.